So this is how to play the second guitar part really. Now I will explain some parts that might need a little bit more explanation. First of all, it's this bend that happens a lot from the 4th fret of the G string really. So, and it's not really a bend to the 6th fret, it's more like a dirty bend. It doesn't go really to a, maybe to the 5th, maybe to the 6th, but it might also be something in between, so it goes like. You can also bend it downwards. I have also seen the guitarists do that live, but yeah, just try out by yourself. It's important that you bend it and then bend it back down. So bend it upwards and then bend it back down. So the second thing that might be a bit difficult is this part of the intro solo really. It's this part. And it looks more difficult than it is, it just goes a bit fast. So I will play it slowly again so you can see what's going on. You really slide this. And it might be a bit difficult to slide your pinky like that into your index finger. Try to practice a lot with your pinky because you do need it more times in this song. And it's really important that you really only play these. There's a G and B string, so. You can also do it with your index finger and your middle finger, like this. But I do advise you to try it also with your pinky and train that a bit, because your pinky is more useful in the song some other times as well, so try that as well. Anyways, that's how to play that part. Then there's another part which requires some pinky stretching that might be a bit difficult, is this part. Then it goes into the chorus. Again, this might be a bit difficult because you need to stretch your pinky quite a lot, but I will play it slowly so you can see what's going on. Like that. Again, you could also use your ring finger, which might make it a bit easier to stretch your pinky, but again, it's less fluently when you're playing this chord to go to this one. So I do again recommend you to try it out with your pinky. Yeah, then the second thing that I thought might be a bit difficult is in the chorus, it's this part. It might be a bit difficult because you need to slide quite a lot, but I will play it slowly so you can see what's going on. And this part is easiest to play if you mute the B string, and you can do that by either resting your index finger on the B string or by resting your middle finger in some way on the E string. Or both, if you want to be very sure that you muted it. Like that. And then this, the last part really that I wanted to explain a bit more in detail is a part of the solo that goes like this. Which looks way more impressive than it is. You first play this 10th fret on the B string, and then put it off to the 9th fret, and then you play the 9th fret of the G string, so. Like that, and you can do it as fast as you like, but try to do it in the rhythm of the song. And then it goes further into the song, so. That's how to do that. And that's really everything I wanted to say about these steps of the second guitar. If there are some parts that you do think are more difficult, play the song at a lower speed. I can't stress that enough. That's really the only way almost to learn the song. Anyways, I hope everything was clear.